I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am solving the problem of overhanging beam, UDL and a couple. Downward arrow positive, upward negative, sagging positive, hogging negative, clockwise negative, anti-clockwise positive. This is the couple, because the couples comes in picture. Converting to point load. I'm converting into point load here. This A, RA, RC. Point load 10 into 1.5. It becomes 15 kilonewton. Here, exactly at the center, 10 into 4.5, 45 kilonewton. 1.5 here, 0.75, half of 1.5, 0.75 this side, and 4.5 half will be 2.25, 2.25, and 2 meter. And there is a couple acting here, 60 kilonewton meter. This A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. Now sum of the vertical forces in order to find out the reaction. 0, 15 minus RA plus 45 minus RC is equal to 0, because the couple doesn't comes in picture when the sum of the vertical forces. Minus taken common, RA plus RC. Being this term in this side, it becomes minus 60. This and this get cancelled. RA plus RC is equal to 60 kilonewton. Equation 1. Taking moment about A. Taking moment about A. Taking the moment about A. That means the couple is comes in picture anticlockwise. Minus 60 plus RC into distance, plus RC into distance will be 4.5 plus 1.5. Next, minus 45 into distance, 2.25 plus 1.5. Next, plus RC, RA into 1.5 minus 15 into 0.75 is equal to 0. If you calculate, the value obtained will be 1.5 RB plus 6 RC is equal to 240. If you calculate, the values will be 240. Consider this equation 2. Now with the help of the calculator, this is RA 1.5 RA plus 6 RC. Now with the help of the calculator, 5, first value is 160. Here 1.5, 6, 240. Now first, it is RB or RA? Sorry, this is RB. RB. This will be RB. Sorry, this I have to take RB. I have taken RA here. RB. The first value of RB is nothing but 26.67 kilonewton. And RC is nothing but 33.33 kilonewton. You have to equate. There are two overhanging. This side also hanging. This is also an hanging. Which in turn, there are two value comes in picture here. You have to go for equating. Now go for shear force. shear force. At D, there is no load, single term, D will be 0. SF at C, on right side, there is no terms, 0. SFC on left side, RC is there. What is RC value? 33.33, and RB is 26.67. minus 33.33. At B, left and right side, on right side, previous value minus 33.33 plus 45 plus 45, 11.67. SFB on left side, previous value minus 2.25, minus 2, sorry, not 2.25, 26.67 is nothing but minus 15. SF at A, there is no load, is nothing but previous value 15, but there is a one more load acting here, plus 15, is nothing but 0. Not the shear force diagram here. This is one of the toughest problem in VTU. SFD, above is positive, below is negative. First is 0. At B, there are two values, 15 and this is minus 15 and positive 11.67. Two values. Next, 33.33. Again here, minus 33.33. 0. 0. Inclined line. Above line. Again, there is an inclined line. 0. 0. Negative, positive, negative. Now go for bending moment. Go for bending moment here. Bending moment. Now bending moment at A, if you calculate, it will be 0. Bending moment at A will be 0 and bending moment at D will be 0. Now I'm go for bending moment at B. Bending moment at B, this is the B part, coupled Cummins picture, minus 60, plus 33.33 into 4.5, minus 45 into 2.25. Calculate, you will get answer minus 11.265 kilonewton meter. Now bending moment at C, bending moment at C, minus 60 kilonewton meter. Kilonewton meter. Next, now at D, bending moment at D. At D, it is a couple, therefore you have to consider left and right. Left, if it is left, minus 60 kilonewton meter or kilonewton divided by meter. Here it is not by, it is not by here, it is kilonewton meter, it is kilonewton meter, it is also kilonewton meter, therefore it is correct, is part. Now 60. Next, on right side bending moment at D will be 0. Now draw the bending moment here. the first value is 0, 0, second value is 11 minus 11.265 kilonewton meter. Next, BM at C will be 60. I will take 60 minus 60 kilonewton meter. At D will be minus 60, again minus 60 kilonewton meter, and 0. Now there is a shear force, maximum shear force occurs here. We have to find out what is the maximum value here. How to find out maximum value? First consider the x distance. Find out the x. How to find out that part? Rewrite this term here. Irrespective of the minus sign, you have to consider. I will consider this is the x. This is 11.67. And this distance will be 4.5 minus x divided by 33.33. Now x divided by 11.67 is equal to 4.5 minus x divided by 33.33. With the help of calculator, you can calculate. You will get the answer alpha x divided by 11.67 bracket 4.5 minus alpha x 33.33. Shift solve is equal to, the x value will be 1.167 meter. The x value will be 1.167 meter. We got the x value. Now we can find out the maximum bending here. Maximum bending. How to find out maximum bending? The previous value plus area of this part. Area. What is the area here? 1 by 2 into 11.67 into 1.167. This is the area. 1 divided by 2 into 11.67 into 1.167. This is the area plus previous value. 6.809. The previous value will be minus. Minus 11.265 plus 6.809. The answer is minus 265 plus 6.809. The answer is minus 4.458 meter, sorry, kilonewton meter. This is the value is obtained. Now it is less than, means it is below the this line. The value will be minus 4.458 kilonewton meter. Now first is parabola, again second will be parabola, third will be parabola. There is a straight line here because there is no UDL. Straight line above. In this way you have to solve the problem when the overhanging beam is given with a couple. I am Satish Gaidankar. Thank you very much.